Coming to you live from the Black Gold 39 studios, this is the Guru Talking Sports Podcast, episode 112. Now here's your host, the Guru of Sports. Listening to the sounds of the Intruders, one of my favorite Mother's Day songs. I always remember this as probably one of the greatest mama songs of all time. I know Tupac's Dear Mama is pretty good, but this one here is just very, very touching because I think it's, for me, it's the original. Hello, sports fans, and welcome. Welcome to the Guru Talking Sports Podcast, episode 112. I am your host, the Guru of Sports. And today, it is the day that we celebrate the lady or the woman in our lives that gave us birth and gave us direction. And gave us the intuition of being a good human being. We celebrate mom on this day. And I just want to say that I took my mom out yesterday. And I took Ms. Guru out. And we had a great time. Went to a nice restaurant. And I did it yesterday because I wanted to make sure that, you know, they didn't have to be crowded or they didn't have to feel like they was rushed or anything. Even though I did feel like I was rushed, I ended up losing a pair of Oakley sunglasses. But I'll get into that a little bit later. But anyway, I just wanted to say happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. I appreciate you. I'm going to talk a little bit more about Mother's Day at the end of the program, at the end of the podcast, at the end, after the bad jokes. I know you guys been really, really hitting me up and telling me about these bad jokes, and I really appreciate it. And I'm going to continue because guess what? That's what I do. Anyway, Mother's Day is very important to me because I still have my mother. I still have actually about three mothers. So I'm going to call all my mothers today and wish them, let me see, one, two, three, four. I have actually four mothers. So I'm going to call all four of my mothers. I know, and four mothers. I have my brothers and sisters from my dad's side. They have, their moms are still living, so I consider them my parents, my moms, his current wife and my mom are still living. So I got four mothers I got to call, plus my sisters and my cousins and everybody. So when we get into Mother's Day, I got a little special something that I want to say to all the mothers out there. I ain't got too much to do today. I'm going to try to break this down into two parts, two halves. And the first half, I'm going to talk about the most stunning upset, the second biggest upset in Kentucky Derby history. I gotta definitely talk about that because I, when I give you these prices, you're gonna flip your wig. Believe me, you're gonna flip your wig. And it is just something else. Plus, I gotta talk about the NBA playoffs, the Sixers, Ben Simmons. I've Ben Simmons in the news again. Yeah, the NHL playoffs. I'm gonna talk about that. I'm going to talk about Phil Mickelson and his problems. And like I said, we don't know these guys. We only can assume about some of these people, but it's pretty dark on what he had to say, on what he had to do. Bad joke of the week, and like I said, I'm going to finish up with some Mother's Day stuff. Thank goodness I haven't had taps in about like 3 weeks, which is a good thing. I really hate taps. I really do. But anyway, I just want to honor my mom's, mothers, everybody out there that celebrate Mother's Day today. I know I sound a little groggy, but I'm okay. I didn't have to battle migraines this week. Not too much. I've been taking my medicine and making sure that I got okay. I'm okay. I did take the dogs out before I came in here, and both Ellie Boo Boo and Alexander, they both went out, and they're okay. So I'll tell you what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut the break short. I usually do about 10 minutes of a opening rant or whatever or so. But I'm going to cut it a little short, take a break, and then we're going to come back and we're going to talk about this Kentucky Derby, which is something that I have never seen in my lifetime. And to tell you the truth, the last couple of years has just been really, really weird with the Kentucky Derby. The Medina Spirit, the Kentucky Derby champion from last year, passed away earlier this year, and it was just bizarre. You got the 30 some odd horses that died over in Santa Anita. I'm going to talk about all that stuff in a few minutes. But anyway, like I said, let me take my first break right here. I'll be back. And like I said, we'll talk about all the stuff on a happy Mother's Day. And I just want to, get you guys to, know that I really appreciate you listening. And like I said, Mother's Day is something very, very good. We're going to talk about all the Mother's Day stuff. We're going to bump out of the break with Mother, with the intruders again. This is the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. We'll be right back with the first half in just a second. Hang with us. We'll be right back. Hang tight. We are back. The first break. Guru Talking Sports Podcast, episode 112. I had to go out and get some Pepto-Bismol. I know. I don't know what it is, but I had that food last night. It was good food. I mean, hey, great food. But I don't know. I think what it was is that I ate a lot of ice cream afterwards. And I'm not really, I'm lactose. I think I'm lactose intolerant with ice cream. So I actually, it didn't agree with me a little bit. Okay, now, enough of my problems. Anyway, I got to tell you, I have never seen this in my lifetime, ever. And the thing is that I usually put a little bit of money on the underdog, just for the hell of it. This year, I didn't even recognize this horse at all, because I don't even remember seeing him race. Rich Strike, 80-1 underdog, pulled off one of the greatest upsets of all time, beating Epicenter in the Kentucky Derby. I have never, like I said, again, I will repeat this until, I'm blue in the face. I have never, ever, ever seen a bigger upset than this. Okay. He only found out that he was going to be in the race Friday morning, and they brought him in. And I think the 20 horse, I can't remember the horse's name, 20 horse was scratched. So he was rolling up in there with a number 21 on. And, you know, I like the number 21. It's not as good as the number 39. But I wanted you guys to know, I've never, ever, ever seen this before. This is, the horse was bought for like $30,000, okay? And it's only raced like maybe six or seven, or less than seven times or so. So, okay, I'm going to, like I usually do, Kentucky Derby, Preakness, Belmont, and Breeders' Cup. I usually give you the big winners, numbers and everything. Now, I bet $80 at the beginning. But I had to cancel one bet because I think it was the same bet I made. So I ended up betting about like $57. I got 12 back. So, you know, you figure that, you know, I lost a little bit. Okay, so what I did was I had the 10, the 3, and the 13 in a trifecta. Guess what happened? The 21 beat the 3, the 10, and the 13. So that's how my luck went yesterday. Okay. All right, now listen to this. Rich Strike won this thing, and it paid $163 to win. $74.20 to place and $29.40 to show. Outrageous, insane numbers. Epicenter, the favorite, number 3 horse, pays $740, $520 to show. And Zandon, $560 to show. Simplification came in fourth, and you know that was it. Okay, now listen to this. Here's the absolute craziest thing. Listen to this. If you played a $1 exacta box or exacta, 21 and 3 paid $2,050.60. A 50-cent trifecta. Listen to this. 21, 3, and 10 paid $7,435.35. A $1 super. Now listen to this. 21, 3, 10, 13 horse paid $321,500.10. Yes, I'm not making these numbers up. This is absolutely true. This is a true freaking fact. Now listen to this. If you had the super five, super high five, a $1 super high five with the 21, the 3, the 10, the 13, and the 1, and I did have a 1 in a couple of exactas or so, paid $741,018.90. Now just think, if you would have played that super high five and put $2 down on that, you'd be a millionaire. You'd be a $1.4 million winner. Outrageous. I've never seen anything like it. I've never seen anything like it. And like I mentioned before in the open, this has been really, really crazy. I'm talking about really, really crazy. The last couple of years, we've seen, like I said, we've seen a disqualification. Medina Spirit winning and then passing away. We've seen all these horses killed over and, you know, all these different things. It is crazy. It is crazy. Horse racing is probably, I usually get down on horse racing every single time. Every single Kentucky Derby, every single Preakness, every single Breeders' Cup, every single Belmont. I do gamble in the Travers. I do with the, the big one up in Saratoga. I like horse racing, but the thing about it is that I've been dealing with horse racing now for about like maybe over 35 years or so. So I mess around. But the thing is, like I said, I've never seen anything like this ever in my life. Even it's ridiculous. It is so ridiculous. And happened on the biggest stage. The Kentucky Derby is the craziest thing. You know, I used to have this horse that I used to bet on years ago. I don't know whatever happened to it. It was called Mountain Bike. That horse brought me a lot of money. Brought me a lot of money. And I used to, at first he was like maybe a 35 or 40 to one shot. I betted on him and he won. And I collected a little bit of coin off of that. But I tell you one thing, I love horse racing, and it's probably one of the biggest things that I do. And I usually try not to, tell anybody usually about the horse racing, but I do mess around with the horse racing. All right. I just can't believe that. And speaking of bad beats, betting and everything like that, I want to ask you guys a question. If you are down 7 runs in the ninth inning, last at bat, ninth inning, can you win? Oh, I'll tell you one thing. The Mets did the Phillies dirty the other night. Thursday night, the Mets did the Phillies dirty. And I tell you, Phillies, I don't know. Mets got your number this year. I think they're doing something special. I'm not a big Mets fan. I like baseball in general. You guys know. But I tell you one thing. The Phillies have not recovered from the Mets. Now, last Sunday or last week, they end up getting no hit by the Mets. And I tell you one thing, the Mets have 3 signature wins this season. The comeback on like a couple Mondays ago against the St. Louis Cardinals, and they had the no-hitter against the Phillies, combined no-hitter against the Phillies. And then this thing here, Thursday night, that was something else. I tell you one thing. Mets might be for real. They might give my Dodgers a run for money. But I tell you one thing, these Mets are amazing. Now, how in the world can you be down 7 runs and end up coming back to win the game? The Phillies in beginning of that inning had a 99.9999% probable chance of winning that game. And the Mets had a 0.00001% of winning that game. And the tables turned and the Mets beat them. And I'll tell you one thing, that was one amazing. I tell you, the announcers for the Phillies were sick. They were sick. And I can't believe that they actually came back and won that thing. All right. Not going to talk too much about, I'm going to go to the NHL playoffs right now. And like I said, I'm going to try to keep this thing short and sweet today. I did watch some Pucks and I did listen to, the Canes get blown out the other night. I know. This is the first time in 4 years that my LA Kings are back in the playoffs. But I tell you one thing, I don't know about this team. They have so many new guys. They have so many new guys that they got coming in here playing. And I think it's just more or less just a learning experience for these guys. But I tell you, I just don't think the Kings have the guns to keep up with Edmonton. You know, Evander Kane, hat trick, like 5 goals in the first couple of games that they played. I can't believe this. They, you know, I gotta give the Kings credit, a little bit of credit, only because they actually came in and, you know, they, like I said, it's been 4 years. They haven't been really good, you know, and I gotta give them credit. I love my Kings, but I just think that they're a little bit overmatched by the Edmonton Oilers. They might, hopefully they can win tonight. If they win tonight, they can even the series, but, you know, they went almost like 4.5 periods where they didn't even score a goal. And Edmonton was just beating up on them really, really, you know. It broke out to a 5-0 lead the other night. And I tell you, I just was really, really worried about my guys. But other than that, the Capitals beat the Florida Panthers the other day. And Washington now leads that series 2-1. The Rangers are down now. They lost yesterday to Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh is now up 2-1 in that series. The Avalanche, they keep on rolling. 7-3 winners over the Predators. They now have a 3-0 lead. And, you know, you got the Stars. The Stars are now leading that Calgary Flames series 2-1. I like the Calgary Flames. I mean, you know, I only root for a couple teams in NHL. You know, I think everybody has to have a classic team. You got to have a classic team, not unless you live in Canada. I mean, I like Toronto. I like Toronto. I like the Golden Knights, and I do like the, you know, like I said, my LA Kings. LA Kings is my team. Ride or die with the LA Kings. Tampa Bay, I can't believe that they're actually down in that series to Toronto. Like I said, I like Toronto. I love Toronto. When I was growing up, that was like kind of like the first, other than the Flyers, when I lived in this area where the Flyers is. You know, Flyers live, Flyers are. But anyway, I've always liked the Toronto Maple Leafs because I like their cool blue uniforms. That big maple leaf on the front of their jerseys, and they always was cool. I didn't like the Montreal Canadiens. I'm not a big Montreal Canadian fan because they always win, and they always beat up. They used to beat up on the poor Flyers. And I told you a couple of weeks ago when the passing of Guy Lafleur, I wasn't a big Canadiens fan at all. So that's my opinion. And that's, you know, like I said, hey, that's who I like. I like Montreal. Don't say that. I like Toronto. I like the Golden Knights, and I like my Kings. That's, you know. I mean, I'll root for, like, teams like Boston, Pittsburgh, the Rangers. You know, I like the Devils, too. I like New Jersey. The Devils are pretty cool because they're like, really close to here. And, you know, I used to have a cool Devils jersey, but I don't know where it's at right now. It probably still is in here. I collect jerseys also. I'm sitting up here wearing my Toronto Blue Jays jersey. My Vlad Guerrero Toronto Blue Jays jersey. I got two of them now. So I usually I'm actually gonna wear my LA Kings jersey later on today to rep the Kings and hopefully give them some good luck. Hopefully they can win and try to keep this series even. All right, I do want to talk about the NBA. What I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about the NBA in the next segment. And matter of fact, we're going to go to halftime right now because, like I said, I got to talk about I'm going to talk about the NBA, the playoffs in there, and then we're going to talk about some Phil Mickelson and his problems. But I tell you what, yeah, let's go to halftime right now. Goldie, are you going to take us to halftime? Okay, like I said, dude, try to keep this short and sweet. It's Sunday morning, the 8th of May, 2022, and this is Mother's Day, and I want to keep it short and sweet because I know that I got a lot of phone calls and I got a lot of stuff to, say to all my family, and I hope that you guys are having a good time with your family out there. If you have your mother, make sure that you, talk to her, wish her, happy Mother's Day. Do something nice for your mom. If you don't have your mother, just remember her in your heart. And like I said, I'm gonna be back in a few minutes. This is the Guru Talking Sports Podcast, episode 112. We're going to halftime, and I'll be right back on the other side. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play the other, my favorite Mother's Day song, and I'm just gonna bump it out here, and then we're gonna go to the half. This is the Guru Talking Sports Podcast, episode 112, and you're listening to the sounds of Tupac. Like I said, we'll be right back after this. We are back. Second half. In the background, you're listening to Tupac and Dear Mama. One of the greatest mama songs of all time. Well, actually, it's a rap. But you know what? I really, really respect Tupac for his rendition of celebrating his mom. It's a good thing. Mother's Day is... It's always, I'm very lucky to be the age I am and to still have my mom and dad. I'm very, very lucky. And like I said, I actually went and took my mom out yesterday and made sure that, she knew that I love her and I care about her. You know, there was a time where we didn't get along. I mean, we didn't get along, and I ended up, I'm not gonna get into that. I'm gonna talk about that a little bit later. But I love my mama, no matter what. God said, if you honor your mom and father, and you respect them, you'll live long. And that's probably one of the things that has brought me to where I am today, and that's why I am the guru of sports, because of that. Okay, now let's get into the last couple of things before we get into the bad jokes of the week, and wrap this thing up because I know you guys love these bad jokes. I know you do, and I've heard. I'm gonna read a comment from somebody wrote me on the email. I'll listen to that. I'll mention that a little bit later. I'm sorry. I'm sitting up. And this is what I do. Every Sunday, every Saturday night or Sunday when I do this podcast, SportsCenter is on. I have a big TV. in my studio, and you know, I'm not bragging anything, but I have a big TV in my studio, and I always have either Sports Center on, or I have the some kind of something for you know, sports wise going on, because I want to make sure that I keep up on what's happening. And I really appreciate just being able to just watch this stuff live and talk to you guys at the same time. Okay, now it's just past the 9 o'clock hour, and Sunday morning. I really like Sunday morning, CBS Sunday morning. It's probably one of my favorite shows. Get up early in the morning, you know, hang out and watch some of this stuff. Okay, I'm gonna talk about Phil Mickelson right quick. How in the hell do you lose $40 million in 4 years? $40 million? That's, man, that is freaking unreal. $40 million. Now, I told you guys that we don't know anything about these guys that, you know, we idolize, and, you know, we know, we really try to respect, and, you know, we talk about, and, you know, I just can't understand it. I just can't understand it. $40 million. Just imagine $40 million. All the stuff that you can do with $40 million. All the, you know, all the jerseys and stuff I can collect with $40 million. Right, you know what? If I had $40 million, I wouldn't act a fool with it. I would definitely try to give back to people. And I would definitely help out the people that I know. I would basically do everything I can to make sure that the people in my life are very, very happy and well taken care of. I just cannot see. I cannot see $40 million just going down the drain. You know, it's just ridiculous. I think that's why Phil Mickelson made those comments about the, comments about the other league over in Dubai or something like that, because I think he was broke, you know. I definitely got to get this book by this autobiography coming out from Alan Shipnuck, forthcoming autobiography. It's about Phil Mickelson, and it talks about the $40 million that he lost between 2010 and 2014. This is ridiculous, man. When I heard this story, I was like, my gosh. Oh, man, this has got really, really, really bad, bad intentions going. You know, or I mean, I just can't understand how in the hell you lose that much money. Wow. You know, he didn't play in the Masters this year because of the comments that he made about the Saudi League, you know. And I understand that. I can't see why he skipped. But the thing about it is that he skipped this because of that. And, you know, Tiger was out there on one leg basically trying to do what he could. And, you know, like I said, I understand that, you know, Phil Mickelson was healthy, you know. But I think that's probably why he didn't get into this, because he didn't want to be asked about all the accusations of him losing this $40 million in 4 years. You know, it's crazy. I'm looking at a quote where it says Mickelson's annual income in 2012 was about maybe was estimated about like $48 million. You know, $48 million. This is ridiculous, man. It's just totally ridiculous. I cannot understand how in the world you lose that freaking money. Man, you know something? And in this economy right now, the way these gas prices are, you're going to lose $40 million? My gosh. Man, you can have like a whole fleet of freaking gas trucks and everything. I think that's what I would probably invest my money in. If I had right now, with the gas prices the way they are, I would open up a gas station. And I would have the lowest prices. And guess what? I would have everybody coming in, filling up, getting them out of here. Lines would be backed up, and I'd be raking in the money. I would sell my gas for about like $2 a gallon. And that $2 a gallon, you'll be busy all the time. And you know, I'd probably make it like I would be in like New Jersey, where I have like people coming out to you and pumping your gas for you and everything and making sure that you got taken care of. But I tell you one thing, if I had that much money, I would definitely own me a gas station. They say car washes are pretty lucrative business too. I find it a lucrative business. You know, I got to find something because like, find something that makes me a little bit more money. But you know, everybody's looking for an opportunity to make more money. But I tell you one thing, I wouldn't try to freaking lose it. Excuse the expression. I wouldn't try to freaking lose it. It's hard nowadays. You know, people are out here. We got this war going on over in Europe and everything. And, you know, I'm not trying to get into the political stuff because, you know, if you want to hear political stuff, go to another podcast because I don't talk about that stuff. But I tell you one thing, the way the thing is now and everything is going up the way it is, I definitely want to own me a freaking gas station or a car wash. Oh, man. But you know, I want to tell you guys, I cannot wait until this weather turns really, really good. Because I'm tired of all, man, it was like a freaking monsoon out here this whole weekend. Now, I was supposed to get home Friday afternoon. I didn't get home until like 2 o'clock in the morning on Saturday morning, yesterday morning. But the thing about it is that I don't mind. Like I said, what I do is I travel around. And that's it. I travel. I have a good time. I love my job. But, you know, it's crazy because I was down in Richmond, Virginia. And coming back was murder because these bridges and up around Washington, D.C., which is the worst. That is probably like the worst ride. Going up there is like crazy. So I try to get through there anyway. All right, let me get back to the subject at hand. Okay, last thing I'm going to talk about on this podcast today, and like I said, this is really, really, really short because I want to make sure that I get Mother's Day comments and stuff in here. The NBA playoffs has been really good. Now, I watched Ja, and he got hurt last night in the Grizzlies and Warriors game. Warriors look good. They beat the brakes off of them. But I tell you one thing, I just cannot understand. And then you got the Gary Payton got his elbow broken and all that stuff. That was terrible. They suspended the other guy for doing it. And I saw the replay and it was really Bush League and dirty. You know, and you don't try to hurt somebody or kill their career. That's what I was getting ready to say. Clay Thompson, he showed up like big time last night. You know, and I think the Warriors are definitely going to put them out of their misery. They beat, Warriors beat the Grizzlies by 30 last night, 142-112. And like I said, it was just beating the brakes off of them. And you see Jordan Poole just running down the court and slam dunking on them. You know, it was pretty bad. They Memphis didn't look good at all. I'm sorry, but they look bad. Boston and Milwaukee, that was a crazy game. That was a crazy game. And now the Bucks are up 2-1 in that series. You know, I thought that Boston could probably win this, but I don't know. I don't know. Boston don't look good. Don't look good. And, you know, I don't know what the hell, you know, they've been doing. And you know, that last play where, you know, Horford tried to tip it in, it was a little bit late. And, you know, it was a mess. All right. The Sixers play tonight. Sixers play tonight, and they did show up, but I got a feeling they're going to lose tonight. I hate to say it, Philadelphia. You know, and the thing is that, you know, no team has come back from a 3-1 deficit. You know, no team has come back off of a 3-1 deficit. And next thing you know, you got Doc Rivers coaching. So one fact that I want to tell you about is that with a in a 2-0 hole, Doc Rivers has never won a playoff series. Now, that's for fact. It's just facts. And, you know, he's blown the other ones. He's blown a lot of 3-1 leads. So, odds are against you, Philadelphia fan. I'm sorry. You know, I like good basketball, but, you know, I gotta admit, you know, they do play a lot better when they have Embiid. And that Embiid mask, I tell you, that's a weird-looking thing. He look like the Phantom of the Opera. He does. He do. He look like Phantom of the Opera. But anyway, that's kind of crazy. All right. So, by the time next week, we should be going into the conference finals. And this is actually, you know, I do want to say something about the Mavs and the Suns. That was a good game by Luka the other night. Now they play tonight, so we'll see where they are in that series. And like I said, this is a crucial game for the Sixers. If they win this game, they can tie this series up. If they lose this game, good night. That's it. That's all she wrote. But anyway, that's the end of the sports section, sports part of this podcast. I think I might try to keep this thing under an hour. Maybe. We'll see what happens. But anyway, I have a comment from a guy named Danny, and he lives in Memphis. He lives in Memphis. He said, man, you are probably the worst joke teller of all time. I wrote him back and said, I thank you, because I do like to tell bad jokes. That's like me. That's my favorite thing. And you know what? I really appreciate people commenting and saying things like that, because, you know, it makes me feel good. I mean, like I said, this podcast is supposed to be very, very, you know, very interactive and, you know, and it's supposed to be fun. You know, you can't be sitting around and just basically just getting upset all the time. You know what? I just like making people laugh when I get a chance to. It's just something else. It's just really, really cool. But like I said, I just want to make sure that I really appreciate you, Danny, for giving me that compliment. And I know bad jokes are bad jokes, but I like telling them. All right. Tell you what, here we go. I'm going to start off bad joke section with this one. Why does Snoop Dogg carry a umbrella? Know why? for drizzle, for shizzle. And that was a good one. Bad joke. All right. They're starting. I know they're starting. Okay. A bear walks into a bar and says, "Give me a whiskey and a cola." "Why the big pause?" asked the bartender. The bear struggled and said, "I'm not sure. I was born with them." Come on, Joe. Oh, gosh. I know, it's bad. They're bad. I mean, they're really, really bad. And I like telling these bad jokes because it makes me laugh. Now, hopefully it makes you laugh, too. I know I'm not the greatest joke teller. But I am a comedian. I don't know why. And you know, the thing about it is that, like I said, this podcast is sports related, but they always put this thing on as comedy. I don't know why. Okay. A man tells a doctor, "Doc, help me. I'm addicted to Twitter." The doc replies, "Sorry, I don't follow you." Get it? "Sorry, I don't follow you. Twitter, I don't follow you." Where's the joke at? It's bad. I know these are bad. These are very bad jokes. But come on, you guys. You guys got to laugh at this stuff. I think it's funny. All right. Anyway, here's one more. I think I tell five a day. Okay. All right. Here's the other one. Okay. Here's another one. Two dragons walk into a bar. The first dragon says, "It sure is hot in here." His friend snaps back and said, "Shut your mouth." Hey, come on. That was good. Okay. One more stupid, silly joke, and I'm done. Okay. Most of these are just weasel, you know, people walk or animals walk into a bar. Okay, here's the last one, and this is a weasel joke. Okay, a weasel walks into a bar. The bartender says, "Wow, I've never served a weasel before. What can I get you?" "Pop," goes the weasel. I know. Terrible, terrible, terrible. I'm done. Okay. All right. That's it. I know. Come on now. That's it. I'm done. All right. That's it. I'm done. All right. I know you guys. I know. Cop, you know, get me, you know, email me and all that stuff. And I'll try to figure this stuff out. These bad jokes, they are bad jokes, but you know they're funny to me. That, you know, come on now, you gotta laugh at that one. "What can you give me?" "Pop," goes the weasel. All right. "Pop," goes the weasel. You don't get it. All right. "Pop," goes the weasel. Okay. Anyway, we're done. All right, I will tell you what. I'm going to give you my...
Want to know how to create awesome videos? Check out motionarray.com.
Not really. I don't know where that came from. It's like just popping up. And I guess a weasel sent that one to me. I don't know. All right, we're done. We're basically done. But I do want to give you my thoughts on Mother's Day. You know, I want to tell you guys that, you know, like I said, if you didn't hear it earlier, I did mention something about, you know, I did take my mom out, you know, and like I said, you know, God tells us to honor thy mother and thy father. You know, no matter what happened or they done or whatever, you know, and I wrote this to my sons a couple days ago. Thing about honor thy mother and thy father, and thy days will be long, came up again. I think it's in Ephesians, and I can't remember the verse number right off, but you know, I do remember that. And the thing about it is that you honor your mother and your father. I wrote to my boys that I honor them too. They honor me and I honor them. And I told them, I said, hey, you know, parents are not perfect, which goes back to my thing about my mom. When I was growing up, we had a lot of conflicts. But the thing about it is that nobody's perfect. I always seen it as, you know, wow, my mom, she does this, she does that, or whatever. But you know what? She really, really cares and loves me and cares about me. You know, it's funny because it's like, my mom is not a very, she's not that type of person that'll show a lot of emotions. You know, she'll say, I love you when you say, I love you back or whatever. But, you know, most of the time that she just basically, you know, goes about her way. She does her thing. She works really hard. She's still working. And she's almost 80 years old. She is actually 80 years old. She still works. I told her, I said, Mom, you need to retire. Take care of yourself. You know, you got all these things going on. You don't have to do all this work. I take care of you. If you need something, I always make sure that you're taken care of. But you know what? She still likes to work. She still likes to get out there and work. And, you know, I got to give her credit for it. And, you know, from what I've seen, her work ethic actually made me the type of worker that I am and put me into the situation of being a better man and making sure that I work hard and I take care of my family as well. But, you know, I look at it this way. My mom is a survivor and a champion of all things. You know, she's had situations where her health wasn't good at one time, but she's healthy now, and I appreciate that. I thank the Lord for that. Like I said, I still have my mom. My mom is very, very, very good with making sure that people are being taken care of. She gives a lot, and that makes a big difference. And she's shown me how to give and to, you know, make sure that, you know, you take care of your family in that sense. You know, like I said, I have four mothers. I have four mothers that I actually recognize. My mom, one of my moms is Ray's, Ray Guru's mother. And I love her because I've been knowing her all my life. And I really respect her because she is the most nicest. I mean, very, very to the core. Never, never, ever in my lifetime have I seen her get mad or be upset with someone. She is the sweetest, nicest woman I've ever known on the face of this earth. And I respect her and I love her and I call her my mom because Ray Guru, Tracy Guru, that's their parent, they're her mom, their mom. And I really love them. I love her, you know. And I claim, and she claims me as her son too because, you know, years ago, I used to come into Baltimore, and I would stay with her. I would, that's the first place I would want to go, stay with her. I know, I go see Dad all the time, but, you know, I always make sure I come see her. Matter of fact, I haven't talked to her in about a month or so, but I'm definitely going to give her a call today. Now, my other mom lives in Las Vegas. Her name is Lily Lane. And that's Derek Guru's mom. And I love her because I respect her because she, when I was growing up, we had our conflicts as well, you know, but the thing about it is that, like I said, I've always been hard-headed or just stubborn or, you know, it's been basically me. But you know what? I respect Derek Guru's mom because the thing about it is that she actually was the one that showed me some tough love. But the thing about it is that when you're growing up, you need somebody in your life to show you some tough love. Hate me now, love me later. I'm going to talk about that in a future episode, But the thing about it is that what she did for me was show me that, hey, look, you know what? You got to toughen up. And she made me tough. And I respect her and I love her for that. I'm going to give her a call a little bit later on as well. Now, another mother that I have is Connie. And she's married to my dad right now. Connie is very, very sweet as well. And she takes very, very good care of my dad. You know, my dad is not in the greatest of health right now. But I gotta give Connie a lot of credit because she stuck it out. She's been there. She's been there with him every step of the way of all the things that he's been going through. And I give her a lot of credit. I give her a lot of respect, even though she's younger than me. My dad, he likes him young. But anyway, I respect Connie. I think that Connie is very, very good, influential. And she takes a lot. She takes a lot of heat. But I tell you one thing, she's a great, great, great motivator. She's a great person, very spiritual, very educated, church going, and keeps my dad in line and makes sure that he's taken care of. And I really appreciate that. And I really appreciate my mom, Derek and Ray's mom. And I respect Connie, and I thank Connie for what she's done. And I'm going to give her a call as well today and make sure that I talk to her. My two sisters, I haven't talked to my sister in Baltimore in a while. I'll give her a call and make sure that she knows that I love her and I care about her. My sister lives in Pennsylvania. She's moving up to Pennsylvania. I haven't talked to her in a while. As a matter of fact, I thought I would see her yesterday when I picked up my mom. But she's actually in Pennsylvania. I love her. I joke around. I mess around with her all the time. She's like my my joke board. I joke around, and I make sure I love her. I care about her. But I joke all the time. Every single time I have a joke, I always, I either try it out on her or I'll make her, the butt of my jokes, but I love her for it and I care about her. So, and my sister-in-laws, I gotta give credit to my sister-in-law, Teresa, Queen. Love you guys, and also Kelly. I love you guys. I love you guys. You guys have beautiful children, and the children are very, very well taken care of by my sister-in-laws, and I really appreciate that. I love you guys. My sister-in-laws, I really love you guys. My cousins, aunts, everyone. I'm going to try to give them a call today as well, too. I want them to know that I love them and I care about them. My barber, I definitely got to try to call her today because she was like a big influence in my life as well. My Uncle Gary's wife. And I love you, Uncle Gary, and I'm definitely going to try to give Aunt Barbara a call today. But I want you guys to know that if you have your mom, pay tribute to her. Matter of fact, do something good for her mother today. You know I joke around sometimes, and I always say that, hey, you know, the guru knows a lot of things, but you know, the guru is not 100% correct all the time with his picks or whatever. But I'm the guru. I do know a lot. One thing I do know is that you have to honor thy mother and thy father. And they always say mother first, because mother is the one that brought us in here and the one that cares about us. You know, even though that you might not think they do, they care about you. They might show it in a different way or whatever. They might not say I love you all the time, but the thing about it is that they do. They love you. They brought you in this world for a reason, and they made sure that you was being taken care of. Even though that some people have rocky relationships with their moms, just give them that respect. This is the day that you're supposed to make sure that your mom is being taken care of. You think about her. You call her. You wish her happy Mother's Day. You tell her you love her. And you make sure that you do the right thing by your mom. Easier said than done, right? But no. Just take some time out. Just take some time out today to thank a mom. You know, I always thank Kaden Guru's mom and Dante Guru's mom as well. Because without them, I wouldn't have any Kaden Guru. I wouldn't have a Dante Guru. And I appreciate their mothers. Even though I did screw up most of their relationships or whatever. Or I might have. I don't. Or it might be on them. I don't know. They kicked me to the curb. Yeah, I kicked them. We're not going to go there. But, you know, we do. We love all the mothers out there. But I want you guys to know that we really appreciate the mothers out there. We appreciate moms. And, you know, next month, we're going to be celebrating dads. We're going to talk about, some dads. And, you know, I only got one uncle left, so I'm going to definitely talk about my uncle, my only uncle that I have living. And I love him very dearly. And I talk to him a lot because, he's a good, great guy. And I love him so much. And I hate to say it, but he's the only uncle I got, and I wish I had more. Wish I had my other ones, but he's actually my favorite uncle. All right, but I want you to know that, you know, I really care about my mom's mothers out there. I want to say happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there that's going to give birth or have given birth. Or if you still have your mom, or if you lost your mom, you know, maybe go to a place. Go to a special place and sit down and talk to your mom in heaven. Do that because, you know, then, you know, let them know that you still have them in your heart. That's the best thing you can do. Let me get out of here. Follow me on the social medias. On YouTube, The Guru of Sports Show on YouTube. Facebook, I'm at Gurus. Gurus. It means The Guru of Sports. Briscoe. Follow me on there. IG, Guru Talkin Sports _ podcast on Instagram. Call me if you can, 302-468-7239. 302-768-7239. Call me. Follow me on all podcast outlets, wherever you get your podcasts. Big props to Miss Mary Mack, and I give you big props, Mary Mack, for being the great person that you are. And I really appreciate you, and I appreciate the things that you do. I really appreciate you. God bless you on this Mother's Day, and remember to find her on the Grief Authority website. That is her website. Big props to my man Jeff Duarte, Cali Sports News, the young GM, my cousins, Curtis, and his grandson are going to be coming on pretty soon. I extended, like I told you, all the people that I mentioned on here are welcome to come on this podcast at any time. So I want you, you know, they're coming up pretty soon. My man Dave May Jr. has been on here 3 times, and he's the reigning king of appearances on here. And like I said, I appreciate him as well. My hip hop brothers, I appreciate you. My D'Luminati Originals, shout out to them. Brothers and sisters, I really appreciate them. Shout out to Mariana. She's an expected mother. I think she already is a mother. And Adriana. So she's a mother, and I really appreciate her. I want to make sure that they know that the Guru cares about them as well. And thanks them for their support as well. The crew, Kaden Guru, executive producer and board op, Ray Guru, technical advisor and musical engineer, Dante Guru, backup co-host and show advisor, and Cousin Aaron, we still haven't been able to get in touch with him, but I'm very concerned because I think he had surgery about a couple months ago, and I haven't heard from him, so I'm definitely trying very, very hard to get with him and trying to find out his condition. But I want you guys to pray for him and make sure that you pray for him and make sure that he's okay. Keep him in your prayers. And his lady, Ann Radel, I'm gonna appreciate her as well. And she's a mother. I wish her a happy Mother's Day as well. Our motto is saying this has been a Black Goat production for Black Goat Entertainment. Copyright 2022. All rights reserved. We don't hate. We congratulate. We always create. And we don't steal from no one. We always give them the credit that they need and earn. Big props to... Use a hashtag big props and the hashtag Guru Talkin Sports podcast. I wanted to give a shout out to everybody. Jamie Dorsey, Miss Denise Hyde, happy Mother's Day to you. Like I mentioned, Adriana, Lori, happy Mother's Day to you. Mel, happy Mother's Day to you. I'm only going to shout out a couple people, but the main thing is Mother's Day today. This is their day, so I want to make sure that the ladies and the moms out there get the shout outs. Now, if I didn't mention you, it's not because I don't want to mention you, but I do care about all the people that support me in this podcast. So all the guys out there, don't worry, I'll get you next weekend. I promise. But this is special. This is Mother's Day, so I want to make sure that I make sure I mention all the ladies. I did mention a couple people. Kate, have a great day. Be with your mom as well, and you know, make sure that you see your mom, Bella B. Make I know that you don't have your mom, but God bless you, and I hope that you know you take some time out to remember your mom as well today. All my friends, I want to let you guys know that I really appreciate you. Appreciate the love and the support that you give me. And you guys go out there and have a great day. Make sure that you check out this podcast. And like I said, next week, it'll be episode 113. We'll be back next week with episode 113 of the Guru Talking Sports Podcast. We will see you soon, and make sure that you guys go out there and enjoy your Mother's Day. Take care of yourself. Take care of your mom. Remember, the Guru will see you real soon. This is one of the best days of the year, and one of the days that I really appreciate because, like I said, I'm very lucky to still have my mom and I still have my mothers that I can actually talk to. So go out there and have a good day. You guys take care. I will talk to you next weekend. The Guru will see you real soon. Take care.
When I was young, me and my mama had beef. 17 years old, kicked out on the streets. Though back at the time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman alive that could take my mama's place. Suspended from school, scared to go home. I was a fool with the big boys, breaking all the rules. Shed tears with my baby sister. Over the years, we was poor and other little kids. And even though we had different daddies, the same drama when things were wrong, we blamed. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell. Somebody else's house just to buy me a new pursuit. I never